Hey YouTube, Gold Purse here. It's been a while and I got a request to do a blow dry braid out video. I'm going to tweak that a little bit because I don't do braids so much because I don't trim my ends that much, and I find that when I try to unravel the braid that it gets kind of undefined. So I'm going to modify it just a little bit and I'm going to do a blow dry twist out video. This is going to be over a period of 3 days because when you blow dry your hair, it doesn't take to twisting as well as when it's kinky. So right now, this is my hair. This is 3 week old dirty hair, and I'm going to wash it, and then I'm going to come back to you when I'm ready to blow dry it so I can show you how I blow dry it, and then I will come back to you again when I'm untwisting it for the results. So hope you enjoy. Hi, so I'm in the process of parting my hair. I just washed it. It's really wet and really shrunken up. And I'm just parting it into four parts. There's one spot. Here's another spot. And I haven't even detangled it because I'm going to do that as I blow dry it in small parts. So I'm just, right now, I'm just finger separating it into four spots. Four parts, rather. All right, and what I'm going to be using for products is Silk Elements Heat Protectant. Especially when you have colored hair, it doesn't matter that it's showing a flat iron and a curling iron. Blow drying on high heat is pretty intense, so you need to do that. So I'll start with that. Blow dry, and then I'll put on this Koils by Nature pomade. That's really awesome. And also another one that I like to use is Oyin Handmade Burnt Sugar, but I ran out of it. It's totally empty, so I love it though. It's really good. Both of them are good. So I have it parted into four parts. Now I'm ready for the drying. All right, here we go. So I'm gonna do a back part because that's what I would ordinarily do. So here we go. I like to have a damp, so if I need to moisturize, like say these spots that I do later, I have my water bottle. It's just water. But this is very damp and wet because I haven't fully dried. So what I do is I take a small part like that. So the fingers. Take a wide tooth comb and gently detangle. Shouldn't be too much work, which it isn't, because it's a small part. And then I take a wider comb. Alright, now it's detangled and now I can blow dry it. Gonna spray with the Silk Elements. I spray it in my hand because it's hard to aim. It's really, really shiny. And it smells good. And it's loaded with chemicals. It's not really good for your hair, but it's good for when you're trying to blow dry it. So, alright, now I'm ready to do the blow dry. I use a comb while blow drying it. Here we go. Oh, this is a Conair. I've always used this. I like it. Alright, there's my first blow dry product. You know what? Because I am doing a blow dry twist out, as I do each small part, I might as well twist it, you know? It's just, that makes it simple. So I'm just going to take a little bit of this, just a little bit, and a little bit more. Let it melt in my hands. And I'm going to twist it. Here we go. One down, 1,000 to go. So here's 1/4 done, and I just banded it to separate it before, after. Now I'm gonna keep it like this for 2 days because, again, I think I already said this earlier, but when it's straightened by blow drying, it doesn't hold the curl so hard. So I don't wanna. I tried to do this already once, and before I did this video, and I took it out the next day, and I was so upset because it just got into a big old puff. So I'm gonna hold this for a few days, and while I'm holding it, I use like old rubber bands to band it. So I'll show you which one. So you can see what I do. I'm not that serious with the banding. I just take this section, you know, and then I just kind of go like that. And then I just stretch it out because I'm not trying to do it that tight or that serious. So. But you can do it as tight as you want. This way when I go to sleep, it won't get like all mushy. So. So there, I usually use two. There's one. Now I want to work on my second one. That's kind of maintain that stretch. And also when I take it out on Thanksgiving Day, it'll be hopefully as long as it is right now. Okay. Ta-da! So I'm done. So as you can see, I banded the two parts in the back together. That's so that when I undo it, I don't have a split in the back of my hair. But this is how I'm going to wear my hair for 2 days. I might take a picture of how I wear it, but I'm probably just going to put it back and maybe wear one side out or something, you know, for work. But on Thursday will be the reveal day when I get to wear it out, twist out. So stay tuned. Hi YouTube, so it's Thanksgiving Day and I'm about to take out my hair. So it's banded from last night. And so I'm going to unband it and I'm going to untwist it for the full result of the blow dry twist out. Alright, so let's untwist and see what we get. You just do another one on camera. There's another one. I'll be right back. So I'm back. Here's the results. This side is a little bit funky because when I try to band it and tuck it, it just kind of is doing its own thing. But what I tend to do when I do these type of twist outs is I don't really fuss with it too much because it's because it's such a loose twist out anyways, it's gonna puff up naturally, so there's no reason to detangle it or to separate the twist. I just kind of go for the snaky look, and then as the day progresses it'll puff out, and maybe I'll take a picture at the end of the night so you can see it. So that's it. I'm not sure what the back looks like, but I'll find out when I take a picture for you. Alright, I hope you enjoyed my video, and I'll see you next video.